From practically the moment the first motor car rolled off the first production line, someone went into the bolt-on goodies business, making accessories to beautify the family saloon. Here at the National Motor Museum stand on the first floor, they've not only got a fine selection of old cars, but a wonderful and hilarious selection of antique accessories as well, like this. Circa 1913, it's called a testaphone. Yes, it is a car horn, but with a difference. It's the precursor of everything we know as in-car entertainment, because somewhere within the body of this instrument, you placed a cardboard gramophone record, a cardboard disc with holes cut in it. And when you pressed the bulb, believe it or not, it played tunes for you. In the early 30s, if you really wanted to confuse people, what better than a pair of these trafficators? Here they are, rather like miniature traffic lights. You bolted them on each side of the car. They had three lights in them, red, amber and green, just like real traffic lights. And the instructions were quite confusing. For instance, if you were turning right, the idea was that you switched the right-hand trafficator onto red and the left-hand one onto green. If you wanted to go straight on, you left both the trafficators at green. The confusion produced for anyone following you must have been beyond description. Now, if it was raining and you had to make a hand signal, remember hand signals, then you could have bought this great British invention, the mechanical hand. It worked from a lever inside the car, and if I move the lever up and down, there we go, waving gently away to the girlfriend across the street, or granny, or anyone else you choose. And for a sartorial note, naturally, in the days before windscreens you had to have goggles, what better than a pair of goggles with sunglasses built in? I don't think they're really me. These accessories cost as much to insure today as most of today's bolt-on goodies do to buy. So let's go and see what's currently available for today's motorist in the accessory line. And let's start off by looking at the latest thing in inspection lamps, this little number from Transtrip. It consumes 6 watts, it has dual polarity, so it doesn't matter which side of the battery you connect it to. But the real difference is it is fluorescent, and it's the first fluorescent lamp to get the AA's seal of approval. What's more, it comes with 10 foot of cable, which can't be bad. New from Trico, a screen washer powered by an electric motor. So what's new about that, you may ask? Well, this is specifically designed for use on the rear screen, so it makes it ideal for estate car owners and the like who have either already fitted Trico's rear screen wiper or have had one fitted on their cars as standard equipment. It complements a rear screen wiper very well indeed. But the big growth area in accessories must be in the area of in-car entertainment, cassettes, cartridges, and so on. And from Radiomobile, a quadraphonic cartridge player. This one works with this machine here and with 4 loudspeakers, 2 at the front and 2 at the back, and each one is adjustable for balance. From Hitachi, another cartridge player over here with a radio built in with wave change, controlled by pushing buttons, which we think must be safer. That must be a good idea. And if you don't want to go in for 4 speakers, but you still want the people in the back to hear the same sort of sound as those in the front, then a pair of these Lucas speakers might go very well. They must have the simplest fixing in the world. A strip of Velcro there. The idea being that you place them under the seats and you attach that strip there straight to the carpet. Again from Japan over here, the entirely portable sound system. Here it is. It's an 8-track player which runs either on U2 batteries, or it runs off the mains, or it runs off a car battery. And as you can hear, works pretty well. And from Philips, the latest in electric motor car aerials. There it is, a new smaller motor, but much more important, both corrosion and water resistant. Really for the first time in electric aerials, and of course, vandal proof as well. But unfortunately, quite expensive. Whatever you say about in-car entertainment, there's one thing it does do. It does while away those eternal hours sitting in traffic jams, trying to get to Earl's Court, for instance.